requested annexation of 95 acres into the city of Loveland. This is the third attempt at this petition this year. It is currently pending before the Claremont County Commissioners, and in fact, they will vote tomorrow at 10 a.m. on this request. I'm asking the council tonight to withdraw resolutions 2021-89 and 2021-96 so we can better review the consequences of this annexation. Loveland has no urgency in supporting this annexation. There's no secret who's behind this annexation. A land development company, Dries. Dries has published a public press release earlier this year stating that they were going to develop this property, even though Dries does not own the property. Dries plans to build over 200 homes on quarter and one-third acre lots. That's from their website, that's from their representatives. Currently, Loveland City Council Resolution 2021-89 in support of the annexation commits us to provide police, fire, water, life squad, sewer inspection services, planning and zoning, street lighting, and stormwater. The resolution further states that the, and I quote, the area will be zoned RLD, residential low density, effective upon date of the annexation, unless the property owners petition the city of Loveland for a different zoning classification and the rezoning application meets the city standards for rezoning of property. Loveland's RLD, residential low density, requires a 1 acre lot. Thus, Dries is assuming already that a zoning change will be granted, allowing for an increase to more than double the amount of homes that will be allowed. What will Loveland receive in return for this annexation? Well, certainly more traffic, traffic being the biggest problem we have. 200 to 400 additional cars through downtown Loveland at least twice a day. Loveland will also gain some additional real income, real property and income tax. But the real property tax income for the city may be limited by law. Perhaps the type of annexation request being made, Miami Township will retain property tax interest over these 95 acres. The Ohio Constitution limits 10 mills to the amount of real estate taxes that can be collected without a specific levy. This is called inside millage. How exactly that inside millage property tax will be allocated between Miami Township and the city of Loveland is unclear. Based upon the Ohio Constitution, Article 12, Section 2, and a 2012 Ohio Supreme Court case, Sugar Creek Township versus the City of Centerville, inside millage is definitely limited to 10 mills. I spoke with the Auditor's Office of Claremont County, other lawyers with knowledge of annexations regarding the real estate tax that goes into a township and a city. No one can tell me how those 10 mills are split. More legal research is needed before Loveland commits itself to this annexation. I've done a lot of the research. Then there are income taxes, but half of the 200 homes that Dries plans to build will be patio homes, and they will be aimed at retirees. Loveland gains virtually no income tax from retirees. The other half of the population will not contribute much in income tax because where they work gets first dibs on the tax. So if you work in the city of Cincinnati, your income tax goes to the city of Cincinnati and not to Loveland. In short, Loveland will gain little in taxes and yet will have to provide police, fire, life squad, water. Nothing has happened because the truth is they want Loveland to provide the water and sewer. This, without that, this development won't happen. It is cost prohibitive to Dries for Claremont County to provide the water and sewer. So Dries wants Loveland to provide that. Loveland residents are being played for fools by another big property developer. And unfortunately, they are being facilitated in that by this city council. Everyone knows the recent past. This council has a history of siding with developers rather than the residents of Loveland. If this annexation goes through tomorrow, Loveland loses much of its leverage and input in the development. Rather than accept the annexation now, Loveland should negotiate with Dries before the annexation. After all, do you negotiate the purchase of a house with the seller before you buy the house or after you sign the contract? You do it before. This development could be a good development for Loveland. I don't know. It could be someday. What I do know is there are too many unanswered questions now, and Loveland is not prepared for this development today. The appropriate action is to delay this annexation until more information can be provided to the council and to the residents. Please rescind Resolution 2021-89 and 2021-96 tonight. It has to be tonight or it goes through. Loveland's future is in your hands.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Here we are.